I don't want to move back to Scotland.
After all I've done for you.
I'm sorry?
And now you're throwing it all back in my face.
I didn't mean to hurt you.
Well, you have.
Jesse, you're in Dublin. Why don't you
pick up the van and hop on the ferry?
Grace, now you owe me one for this.
I want custody of Iona. And I want your backing to help me get it.
For what it's worth, I'll do anything to help.
Good, because I've got something to ask you.
Maggie, what?
I want you to help me die.
A wee peace offering for yesterday. Shall I just take her out the pram?
Oh no, she's fine in there. Here we are.
What do you mean the van's been picked up?
Cheers, mate. Go safe.
I didn't send anybody.
You know I didn't mean to snap at you yesterday, right? I just must be letting everything get on top of me.
I know you are, love, but Granny's here to take the strain off.
How could you not tell me there were drugs?
No more questions, Grace. I just want to know you got the best man on the job.
Yeah, it's fine.
Who's driving that van?
I told you, it's nobody you know. But he's sharp, all right? I promise. He knows what he's doing.
He better do, Gracie.
I told you, don't worry about it.
Mr. Donovan, do you have a minute, please?
Yeah, he's all yours. I'll meet you at home. I need to make some calls.
I wondered if you had time to consider my proposal of yesterday.
Yeah. A child's place is with its mother. She looks perfectly capable from here.
Well, and that's enough for you. But she's your granddaughter, you know.
I'm afraid you'll have to do without my money.
Thanks. Look, if there's any change to her condition at all, please can I be the first person that you call. And look, I'm really sorry to keep bothering you. I'm just really worried about her. Okay.
Hey.
Suspects to be identified. That surveillance I set up in town's catching all sorts upon life. We've got more dealers in the streets, stronger gear in their pockets. I'm thinking we've got a new major player in town. Nighty, see someone you recognise?
No.
See you in a bit.
See ya.
Jesse, it's me again. Will you please answer your phone? Can you just give me a call back when you get the chance, okay? Hey.
You look tense. Who was out on the phone?
No one, just a friend. What did Courtney's gran want?
Who's driving the van, Grace?
I told you, just don't worry about it, right?
Who's driving the drugs?
Jesse, okay? It's Jesse.
What's the matter with you? What if Annie Di or Lily were in? Just leave us alone.
Not until you've heard me out.
Oh, well, I already know what you're going to ask us so I can save you the trouble because I'm not going to help the old mother die.
What, you'd rather watch me wither away, is that it? Because that's what's happening. You think I want to spend the rest of my life in constant pain? Is that what you want?
No, of course not, but people will take care of you. There's loads of help available.
I want you to help me. I'm not asking you to do it now. I'm talking weeks down the line.
Oh, well, that's okay then. Because, I mean, you know, I've just got quite a bit going on at the moment, so why don't you send us some dates and then I can check my diary and see what works.
Can you stop making your stupid jokes for 1 minute?
The only joke around here is you. You're a joke of a mother who just threw me aside like I was a piece of rubbish. And now you finally want something to do with us and it's to help you die. Well, here's a thought for you, Maggie. Why don't you ask Damon to do it?
No.
No. Because, I mean, you wouldn't want to saddle that on the one son that you actually love, would you? But it's fine to rope in old Scott the pushover. I mean, who actually cares about his feelings? And hey, he tried to commit suicide himself before, so at least he knows what he's doing.
He never even crossed...
I can see through all of it, Maggie. All I ever wanted was for you to want me the same way that you wanted Damon. And now, when you finally do want us, it's to help you end your life. I knew you hated us, Maggie, but this...
No, I don't hate you, Scott. And I'm not asking you to do this because you're a pushover or anything like that. It's the opposite. It's because despite everything I've put you through, you're the strongest out of the lot of us. You're the only one who can do this.
Grace, you are not going to believe how good I look in my new trackers at.
Where are you?
I might think of a career change, you know? Just me, the rig, open road. I mean, no one can say I don't look the part.
Jesse, just shut up and tell me where you are right now.
All right, customs. Yeah, I've been here ages. I'm almost through now, though. Is everything all right?
Jesse.
Yeah?
Nothing, I just wanted to check that you were okay. Have you had any problems?
Aww. You give it the big one, but you're real softy, aren't you? No probs so far.
Oh, Grace, you'd have laughed this morning.
Listen, Jessie, I've got to go, all right? I'll speak to you later. Just be careful. Why wouldn't you let me tell him?
What do you think a van pulling a U-turn at customs is going to look like? Do you think it's going to look remotely suspicious? Do you even think at all?
He'll be okay, Glenn.
He better be, Gracie.
Oh, did you enjoy your nap? Are you ready to be a good girl for the social worker? Oh, you're going to be a smell girl, I see.
Just slipping out to the spa, dear. I won't be back till later.
But you're going to miss the visit from the social worker.
Oh, you're more than capable of looking after yourself, Courtney. I think you made that quite clear.
Fine. I guess I'll see you when you get back then.
The way you came through yesterday and dragged me and Damon together, that took character. You know, that's why I came to you.
You're only saying that because you want me to help you. You don't respect me or anything like that. You never even wanted us.
Of course I wanted you, Scott. Giving you up was one of the hardest things I've ever had to do.
So why did you do it?
I hoped I'd never have to tell anyone this. But a long time ago, I used to be a prostitute.
What?
Until I got pregnant. I used to dream of making enough money to make a go of it. To make a life for us. I was so depressed some days, it was the only thing that pulled me through. It was going to be me and my baby against the world.
So what happened?
Reality happened. I couldn't make the money I needed. I couldn't get the work once I started to show. And eventually that baby arrived. And I wanted to give you the life I dreamt of, Scott. I really did. But the day came to take you out of that hospital. And I couldn't. Because I had nowhere to go. So I left without you. But you have to believe it killed me. It felt like I left a piece of me in that hospital.
But I came back to you. I found you, and you didn't want anything to do with us.
When you turned up on my door that day, I should have been overjoyed. I should have made amends. But I didn't. Because when I looked at you, all I felt was shame. Shame at the life I'd spent 30 years trying to hide from everyone close to me.
Yeah, but that wasn't my fault.
No, it's mine. It's all my fault. And I'm just sorry that it's taken something like what's hanging over me to make me come to terms with it.
I guess that's the story of me and you, innit?
bad timing.
I should go. I've caused you enough pain.
Forget about what I asked you to do.
Wasn't fair. I'm so sorry, Scott. You deserved so much better.
Mom!
Good night, was it last night? I recognise the hoodie.
It's not mine.
You're wearing it now, Steve. Right, stand up, you're coming with me.
Why?
Where are we going?
I said, stand up. Now, we can either do this the easy way or the hard way.
What are you transporting today?
Oh, you know, a couple of boxes of dynamite, a few species of endangered bird. It was just a little... bricks. It's just bricks.
Can you open the van for me, please?
You know, that was just a joke, right?
From social services. I didn't catch you by surprise, did I?
No, no, of course not. Sorry about the mess. I just need to find this dummy. It always shuts her up. Not shuts her up, just, you know, quiets her down.
Why don't I look after her while you look? Promise I'll give her back.
Yeah, sure.
Hello. I think she might have left us a little present.
I know she has. It's just... my gran must have left them up there. She's been giving me a hand with Iona. Not that I'm struggling or anything.
Courtney, it's fine. I understand. It can be stressful being a...
disabled?
New mother. But that's what I'm here for. Arrangements can be made if...
What sort of arrangements? Is that your way of saying you can take her off me?
It's my way of saying that there are support systems in place, if you're struggling.
But I'm not, though. Honestly, you've just caught me in a bad day, that's all. Sorry. Just give me a minute. She loves this dummy. She won't go to sleep without it.
Jessie should have been here half an hour ago.
Are you not even worried? Surely there must be something else we could do.
I don't know. How about hiring him a lawyer? Or better still. How about not getting involved in the first place?
Don't put this on me. If you'd have just been honest and told me what was in the back of that van. Oh, if you weren't such a sexist pig.
Oh, so it's sexist to keep your woman out of harm's way now, is it?
Well, it is when you think it's because I'm not capable.
You're not capable. Next time you want to stick your pretty little nose into my business, into real business, remember today, the day when you very nearly got your own brother...
Did someone order some bricks?
Little gift from the Emerald Isle. Oh.
It's only $2.99 for a service station. Calm down.
I would have got you something, Dad, but I didn't know you'd be here.
You got me my cargo, son. That's more than enough.
You all right?
She's just pleased to see you. I don't blame her.
come on. But he's going to take me to prison.
What's the point? Because you seem pretty determined to get there without my assistance. I mean, what were you thinking, you idiot?
Well, that's the difference between me and you, innit? Hey, you hide from who you really are, whereas me, I just embrace it.
Oh. Beautiful words, Steve. Why don't I give Lyra and Lucas a call and you can relay that little speech back to them. Let them know that their dad's given up and he's gone back on drugs.
Right, well, go on then, do it. I'm not even bothered. I've already lost them anyway. And now I've lost my sister. You know that Tegan, she's only in a coma right now because of what she saw, Ryan. It's because of us.
I know. Look, I'm sorry for shouting at you. I just get frustrated because I've seen how hard you've worked to try and kick the habit. I mean, I've watched you come back from things that would have killed me. Losing the kids, getting locked up from Amy's murder. I mean, stuff that I couldn't have coped with. You're so much more than your addiction, Steve. I mean, you're funny, you're kind, you're intelligent. At least that's what I thought until you get caught on camera picking up and going on a bender.
I wanted to. I still want to.
I'm taking my family for dinner tonight, and I want the van and its contents removed by the time we've finished.
Oh, Mr. Donovan, I saw you passing. I wanted to apologize for bothering you earlier. You were right. I'm sure there was nothing to worry about.
Don't worry, Mrs. Campbell. There's no problem. You're like me. You just care too much.
Oh, indeed. What are we like, eh? Courtney? Oh? Whatever's the matter, dear? Oh, no. Is Iona all right? Oh.
So why didn't you take it?
Because I have to find another way of dealing with my problem sooner or later. Doesn't mean I wouldn't have caved, though, if you didn't turn up when you did. Next time, I might not be so lucky.
Next time, you'll be arrested.
Thank you, Ryan. And I mean that.
No, I better go to work. Got some real criminals to catch.
Will you be able to?
No. You will.
Sorry.
Me too.
Courtney, I'm going to be dropping in periodically to make sure you're still doing all right.
Okay.
Okay.
Sorry again. It's not usually this chaotic.
Dear, Glenn came to see his granddaughter. For goodness sake, what happened here?
I think they're going to take Iona away, Granny. That visit was an absolute disaster. I've lost Iona's dummy and she hasn't stopped crying since.
Oh, what did I tell you about trying to take on too much by yourself?
Well, I thought I could handle it. And now the social worker said she's going to be coming back. What if I'm on probation or something?
Got it. Under the sofa. It's where I always look.
Oh, thank you so much. Look what Granny found. Let me just go sterilise it and it's all yours.
I'll support you becoming Iona's legal guardian, but it's on the condition that you and Iona remain in the village. I like my family where I can keep an eye on them.
Did you hear that? Oh, I can't wait to get you back to Edinburgh to show you off to all my friends. No more distractions, no more fair weather mothers. Just you and Granny. Uh-huh. Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Are you Jesse Donovan?
Yeah.
What are you bothering him for?
Would this be the van you drove through customs today, Jesse? We had a little tip-off from an informant, you see.
Oh, look, I was only joking about those endangered birds. I'll show you myself if you want.
I think you'd have been better off with those birds, Mr. Donovan. Keys.
Just hang about. It's not mine.
I'm arresting you on suspicion of importing Class A drugs. You do not have to say anything, but it may harm you.
Grace!
If you do not mention when questioned something which you later rely on in court, anything you do say may be given in evidence.
Listen to you go. Finally a family member with a voice. My demo school nativity never even had any musical numbers.
Well, neither did ours. This was all my own improvisation. In fact, I'm carted off in a minute. Look. Hey, I had me moment, though. That'll teach Mr. Robbins for casting me as shepherd number three. I wish we'd had more nights like this.
Bad timing, eh?
I meant to ask you earlier about me dad.
I don't know. I'm sorry. After I've gone, the things I told you earlier about me being...
I'll never tell a soul, I promise.
I'm not proud of who I was back then. But I am proud of you now. And you were right earlier. I do worry about Damon too much. I always have done. But nothing gives me greater comfort than knowing he's got a big brother like you to look out for him after I've gone.
I'll do it. If it's what you want, I'll do it. I'll help you die.
Well, support information for the issues raised can be found online at channel4.com/support. Later, Professor Green meets more young lads as they try to craft out a future in today's Britain. Working class white men at 10.
Good night.